This is another Fox News alert. Moments ago, Alabama Governor Kay Ivey signed one of the strictest abortion bills in the country into law. Correspondent Jonathan Serrie reports on the firestorm ignited on both sides of this debate, one that could very well lead all the way to the U.S. Supreme Court.
The Republican-controlled state Senate voted 25-6 to make it a Class A felony for doctors to perform abortions in Alabama unless the mother's life is in danger. The measure makes no exceptions for cases involving rape or incest.
Life is a gift of our Creator, and we must do everything that we can to protect life.
Outrage from state and national Democrats soon followed.
I apologize to the women of Alabama for this archaic law that we passed.
We need to lift up their voices. We need to lift up the voices of women and families across America who see their civil rights and human rights being taken away from them.
Democratic presidential candidate Kirsten Gillibrand plans to speak tomorrow at a women's rally in Georgia, where Republican Governor Brian Kemp signed a similar bill last week. The Georgia law has sparked calls for a boycott by the state's $2 billion film industry that supports nearly 1 million jobs. Actress and activist Alyssa Milano called for a national sex strike, tweeting, "Until women have legal control over their own bodies, we just cannot risk pregnancy. Join me by not having sex until we get bodily autonomy back." Debate over Alabama's bill has been fierce. Last week, the gloves were off when a shouting match on the Senate floor delayed a vote. The legislation will likely face an immediate legal challenge.
It's designed in every way to do just that. That's why we were trying to keep it just as it was to address the issue that Roe versus Wade was decided on, which is that baby in the womb a person?
Supporters say they want the case to be taken up by the U.S. Supreme Court. As the makeup of the high court becomes increasingly conservative, the chances of overturning Roe v. Wade become increasingly possible. Brett?
Jonathan, thank you. More on this with the panel.